Welcome back to the fabulous Olympic Oval here at BASELGA DI PINE in the Trentino region for continued coverage from the FISU World University Speed Skating Championships. We've got highlights from the women's 500, men's 500, and then into the fun of the mass start to conclude our coverage here on Eurosport from these championships. Well, weather conditions are pretty good. We've had some evening races, but back into the sunlight for our day racing today to conclude the coverage, and it really does paint a quite beautiful picture. This facility last used for the Universiade in Trentino 3 years ago now. What a fabulous tournament that was, and an opportunity once again for the students to return to what is basically one of the hotbeds of European speed skating, and in particular Italian speed skating. Well, that's how things stand after the first 500 meter race. They will be seeded based on those times. The racers, Qishi Li of China, the fastest at 39.430, and she will go alongside Arisa TSUJIMOTO of Japan. They will be paired up as the last pair based on the seedings to see if in their second 500 meters they can joust it out for that gold medal. So this is how things will line up. It'll be Marin Sarap who goes off on her own for Estonia, then Krotova and Yang, Belarus and China, and then Boarding and Dramalova of the Czech Republic, and then moving down to the faster seeds, it'll be Li Qishi and Arisa TSUJIMOTO that finish things off. Maybe Takahashi can get in amongst it as well. Japan have a good strong side here. Nana's sister incidentally competing at the moment in the World All-Round Championships, Miho. But now her here at these University Speed Skating Championships. So just about ready to get things underway. A little bit of a lonely moment for Marin Sarap. But going to try and complete this 500 metres as quickly as she possibly can. The Tallinn University IT student, in her third year, competing in the 500, 1,000, 1,500, and we will see her in the mass start as well. I think we're going to see quite a stretched out field in that mass start race, 16 laps of this track later today. A little bit ungainly coming round the corner, but trying to keep the power down, looking for a time as close to the 40 seconds as she can get. PB of 43.410. And now the drive for the line will look a little bit more animated when we have two athletes out on the track, and crosses the line in 44.59. So 44.59 to go with her first time of 44.318, a little bit slower. Second time around, yes, didn't get away to the best start there, Marin. But stuck with the task all the way through. Now Maria Krotova, 42.41 for Krotova. She'll be paired alongside Yang Ji of China. Yang Ji with a time of 43.010 in that first race. So similar times, but you would expect Krotova of Belarus to get the drop in this one. Just a sprint away and a couple of little slips there from Krotova, but keeping this power on all the way down, not settled into her skating rhythm yet, and that's a good piece of work from the Belarus athlete. So the speed in the skates, now trying to transfer that into power throughout this race. Good low body position from Yang, but she's not quite in the same quality as Krotova. And Belarus looking to create a decent double time here for the points, somewhere in the low 80s, and gets across the line in 42.23. Yang Ji, 43.88 her time, so sub 43 seconds from Krotova. We will see, I'm sure, some sub 40 skating as well. That'll be when we get to the lower seeds. Well, fast and furious when it comes to 500 metres. 13th in the 1,000 metre race at El Yasmin Boarding of the Netherlands in the distinctive orange suit up against Eliska Dramalova of the Czech Republic. Her compatriot Sablikova bidding for another all-round title at the moment in Berlin. Plenty of speed skating going on at the moment across Europe. And Dramalova in the red and blue to the left of your picture in the outside lane. Slightly more staccato steps from Boarding. And both working very hard down that straight. Neck and neck then into the split as they head round this first corner. Boarding with the inside lane gets that brief advantage before skating across to the outside lane to finish off her 500. A lot of intent about that from Dramalova. And now gets that inside line, but just a little too wide from the Czech Republic skater. So the Netherlands look like they're going to set the faster time here. And that's what they do. 42.11 from El Yasmin Boarding. So moves her into top spot at the moment. 84.180 on that dual classification across both races. From Dramalova's point of view, 85.350. Final points tally. Well, a little bit scrappy towards the end from Boarding, but a solid enough time. But plenty of quality seeded to come, so we will see those times beaten. Sanna Vesterveld then. Decent time of 41.372. in her opening heat, and 41.260 is her PB, but 48.60 is Zenia Skarovorodkina's time, the Belarus athlete in the green on the outside lane. On paper, the faster of the two athletes here, but Sanna Vesterveld putting in a decent effort here, pushing very hard indeed. And this is looking good for Vesterveld. And a little bit scrappy from Skovorodkina. Well, she's settled into a rhythm now, but I think the damage has been done here. And Vesterveld with a real chance of recording the faster time. Yes, you're racing against the other person on the ice with you, but it is ultimately against the clock. And Vesterveld hanging on. That's really strong from the Dutch woman. 41.82 against Zenia's 42.11. And Vesterveld moves into the lead. Well, this is what we want to see with the way that the seedings work in reverse order through this second round of 500s. You want to see a constant improvement. And as athletes cross the line with each pairing, you want to see that lead changing hands. And at the moment, stays with the Netherlands and Sanna Vesterveld. Steffi Wuppen then of the Netherlands going next against Linda Bortolotti of Italy. Enrico Fabri looking after, there he is, right on cue, looking after this Italian team. The Olympic medalist has been the mentor for this student team coming into these championships. They've had mixed results, but they've had a couple of really good ones. Now, in terms of PBs, these two are absolutely neck and neck. Virtually nothing between them. Bolotti is just a little quicker. And Bortolotti just gets to the outside line first, but then the lanes allow Wuben to temporarily take the lead. She'll drift across to the outside lane now. Bortolotti will switch to the inside. And at the moment, Netherlands look like they're going to retain the lead in the 500, but it will switch hands if Wuben can keep this going. But Bortolotti coming back strong. This is a good effort from the Italian, and this is going to be fast from her. It's going to be just over the 41 mark. 41.05 for Bortolotti. 82.620, and this home crowd here in Basegla can celebrate that one. Well, for so much of that race, Steffi looked like she had it. But Bortolotti got things together just in time. the faster woman, marginally faster woman on paper, getting that across the line for the lead. So Italy at the moment with the lead, two pairs to go. Nana Takahashi, part of that fantastic Japanese pursuit team, along with her sister Miho. Alexandra Kapruciak of Poland, just off the podium in the 1,000 meters. Kapruciak, so looking to try and get on the podium here in the 500. The second 500 for these two then. Very fast in the first. Nana just over the 40 as well as Kapruciak. Nothing between these two. Can they push each other on? Good advantage then at the moment. 2/10 for Takahashi to play with here to put her into top spot. But Kapruciak is waiting for an error. And this could be the skate for the bronze medal, depending on what happens with our final two seeds. And Takahashi determined it's going to be her. And the Japanese racer gets to the line first. It's a good time. 40.53. 81.170 for her points classification. That puts Nana Takahashi into top spot. But it means that Kapruciak is going to have to wait and see. She may have to suffer another fourth place here, and that would be unfortunate for the Polish skater, because that was a good time. The two fastest skaters then from the first 500. Arisa Tsujimoto in the darker of the two speed suits for Japan, the silver medalist in the 1,000 meters, up against the 1,000 meter champion from this World University Speed Skating Championships. And Li Qishi in the red speed suit. Very purposeful drive all the way down the straight. Two quite different styles. You can see how low Tsujimoto is, and then control it. Control the speed round the bend. Keep plowing the power through the skates, and that's exactly what Lee is doing. But Tsujimoto is not letting her have this all her own way. This is going to unfold very nicely off the bend, and it's going to be a really tight finish. We could see two racers under the 40-second mark here. Brilliant skate from Lee. It's going to be a second gold medal for the woman from China, and Tsujimoto picks up the silver. Wow, that's fast. 39.41 against 39.79. And the two fastest skaters from round one saving their best until last. A very good second round. And it's another gold medal for Lee. Well, Lee has a fantastic PB at 37.930. So not quite going to that level, but Tsujimoto not far off her personal best. And confirmation, that gold medal going to Lee. Silver to Tsujimoto. And Takahashi once again just keeping Kapruciak of Poland off of the podium. So just a little unfortunate for the Polish skater, but the Chinese skater Li dominant from start to finish in that one. So that's it for the ladies 500. We'll be hearing from the Hungarian skater Konrad Nagy after the break, and then we'll be moving over to the men's 500. And there's that final classification score. Quite a decent advantage in the end for Lee to take that gold medal.
Follow the World University Championships. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.